Hey, it's Jeremy here, and today I want to be showing you how to create this paper cutout effect in Illustrator. You can see we added some texture, a bit of color, and using some shadows, you can get this really cool layered effect, and you can get that illusion of, you know, paper stacked up together, which looks really cool. So I'm going to show you how to do that. You can use any color palette. You know, I'm just using this orange color palette that I like, but you can use your own. So first up, we're just going to have a normal artboard. It can be whatever color you want. So first up, what we're going to do, we're going to have an artboard, so it can be any size you want. And I'm going to start with using the pen tool. So I'm going to press P for the pen tool. It's also located on the left-hand side here. And what I'm going to do now is just zoom in a little bit, holding the Alt key and the scroll mouse, I can zoom in. And I'm just going to go to the left-hand side and left-click. And now what I'm going to do is, you see the path is already started. I'm just going to click and drag and start to do these curvy waves. And then I'm going to click on the edge of the artboard there. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to find the corners and just click. Because I don't want to keep it messy. I want to keep it clean. So you can see I'm just going to keep it within the artboard. But, you know, you can put the paths outside if you want. But I just like having it like that. So you can see it's a bit too high. So I'm going to select it with the normal selection tool. And I'm just going to scale it down a bit. And what I can also do is use the direct selection tool, which is the white arrow. And what I can do there is click and move them around like that and just play around. You can also see it's got these handles. I can also move these handles so I can affect this curve if I don't like the curves, because you want to make it look organic as possible. You don't want to make it too square. So cool, so I've got this. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to go to my appearance panel. I'm going to go to my appearance panel on the right. You can go to Window, Appearance up the top, and you'll get this window pop up. What we're going to do is on the left-hand side, you can see it's got an FX button. We're going to left-click on that, go up to Stylize, and Drop Shadow. So what I'm going to do now is, you can see I've already got these settings pre-put in there. So I'm going to click Preview on the left-hand side, and you can see that it's added that Drop Shadow to the shape. And you can see how it's up and not down. Usually drop shadows go below. It's because the Y axis or the Y offset is -7. If I bump this up, you can see it goes further up. If I just bump it down, I'm holding shift to go up by tens. But if I bump it up down, you can see it's going to go below it. But we won't want it to go up because our paper cuts are going upwards. So I'll put it to around 7, 8. That's fine. You want to put the mode on multiply and you want to put the opacity a little bit lower than 70% or 80%. Because you don't want it to be too harsh. And then the blur, you can play around with that, but I have it on 9 and it looks pretty cool. So I'm going to press OK. And what that's going to do is going to save that drop shadow to this shape. And what we're going to do is actually duplicate this shape now. So I'm going to left click on this shape, holding Alt and Shift. And I'm going to click and drag at the same time and drag that upwards. And you can see now this is on top of this shape, but I wanted to bring it below. So go to Object, Arrange, and you want to go Send Backward. So now we have this shape behind this shape, and it's starting to get layered with this nice shadow effect that's hitting this color. And what I'm going to do now is actually change the color. You can change to any color. You can see I've got these other colors here, which look still pretty cool. But I want to go for this gradient effect using this nice orange hue. So we have that. And once again, I'm going to go through here. Use a direct selection tool. The shortcut key is A. And I'm actually going to go move these anchor points and these handles, move them around, you know, make it look organic. I can even drag these points down to make it look more abstract if I want. And I can even add some anchor points by pressing P for the pen tool and just left clicking on the path. And it's going to add. Make sure you select the shape and then click it. And then you can see I can go ahead and play around with that. I can move the edge like that. So cool. That's looking cool. Once again, because we've already copied this shape, it has the drop shadow already. So we don't have to reapply it, which is super handy. So I'll just copy it, bring it up, and I'm going to center back. So Object, Range, Center Back. You can see I'm using the shortcut key, which is Control and the left square bracket, which is next to the P on your keyboard. And that's going to bring it down. And I'm going to change the color. Once again, play around with these. You want some cool curves. Just think of like mountains. Play with these handles here. Duplicate it. Use the shortcut, bring it to the back. You can see that it's not reaching here. So I'm just going to double click, go into isolation mode, and then I'm going to select these anchors and just drag it down. And then I'm just going to hold shift and click and drag that down so it's longer. So we're not getting any gaps. And then one more, we'll drag it up. And for this one, we can cover it, or we can leave a bit of white space at the top. What I'm going to do is that looks pretty cool. And what I can do, I can use the shape builder tool. So I'm just going to make a box. Hold shift, select these two shapes. I'm going to go to my left, to the left, and you see the shape builder tool here. I'm going to hold my alt key. If you're on a Mac, it's going to be option. And I'm just going to left click and minus off those shapes there, like that. So it's all clean. I prefer to keep it like that. It's super handy. And you can see, if I don't want these gaps, I can just take it out. I can just delete these anchor points here. Just depends what you want it to look like. I can just join those up. So I can leave it like that. Cool, so that's looking good. Now what we're gonna do, we're gonna add some texture. So you can leave it like this, that looks pretty sweet, but it does look a little bit flat, but we just wanna make it, give it that paper effect. You don't have to use paper textures, you can use different ones. You can use leather, you can use like grungy textures if you want. And that's what I'm gonna use. I'm gonna use some textures from my texture pack called Fine Grit. And you know, it's got a mix, it's got cloth, it's got some wood, cement and stuff. It's pretty sweet. So I'm just going to drag some textures from here. And they're all going to be a little bit different. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to send all these to the back. So object, arrange, and you want to send to the back. So make sure it's all the way at the back. So now you can see it's all under these shapes. So what I'm going to do now, we're going to make clipping masks for each shape. So I'm going to select all these shapes we made. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to press Control C to copy. I'm going to press Command 2 or Control 2 to lock these. You can also go Object Lock Selection. So I'm going to do that. And now all these are locked. And because we already copied these shapes, it's in the clipboard. So all I have to do now is press Control F. And it should paste it in front. See, there was a bit of an error there. I redo that. Select them all. Control C, Control, lock that, and Control F. So once we've done that, I'm gonna go ahead and actually duplicate all these shapes. So I'm gonna select it. I'll press Control C, and then I'll lock that by pressing Control 2, and then I'll press Control F to paste in front. And now it should paste those shapes on top of those shapes there. I'm gonna use these for the textures to make clipping masks. So one by one, I'm going to get these textures, doesn't matter what order, and I'm gonna scale them up. These are TIFF files, so you can scale them, you know, you can put them in masks, and they're really handy. They're bitmap textures and look really good. So I'm gonna select this and hold shift, select the texture. And what I'm gonna do is go to object, clipping mask, and make. The shortcut key is there, it's Control 7 or Command 7. So you can see that we've got that texture now. And you can see, because we've got all these other layers, we have to finish doing all these ones, and then we can make sure they're on the right part of the layer. So I'm gonna do it for the rest. And I'm gonna use the shortcut key for this one. I have an action which makes it quicker. I put it on F5 and unclipping is F6. So scale, select the texture, scale it. Make sure it's over all the whole shape. Hold shift, select the shape, and then clipping mask. And then the last one, like that, hold shift, select it, make a mask. So now you can see we've got all these shapes, but now they're all over the place. We have to bring it down. So we'll start with the back here. So you can see it's covering. What I'm gonna do, I'm going to go object, arrange, send to back. And then I'm gonna go object, arrange, bring forward. And make sure you use the shortcut, it's quicker. Bring forward. I'm gonna press control and right square bracket. And there you go. Because this artboard is on the same layer, it might take a little longer. So I'm just gonna quickly put these on their own layer and lock that. So now it should only take a few. So once again, I can bring it to the back and then just go up from the back until it's on that. It goes on top of this layer here. So you can see that. And then this one is fine. So cool, that looks good. Now what I can do is I can select all these textures. And you can see the selection, what it's doing, it recognizes the texture within the mask. So the when you put your mouse over it, it just shows you the preview, but when you click on it, it's selecting the shape. So keep that in mind. I'm going to go to my transparency panel now, change the blending mode to multiply and put the multiply to 40%. Like that. And there we have it. It's nicely blended the textures there. You can see that bitmaps. Looks pretty sweet. And there we have it. There's our paper cutout effect. Hope you liked this tutorial. Let me know in the comments below on what tutorials you want to see, and I'll post some more. And don't forget to subscribe for more content every week.